Every month, the mobile space is filled with new games, and every month, GameRanks goes through and finds the best ones for you to try. Hi, folks, it's Falcon, and today on GameRanks, the 10 best free iOS and Android games of July 2020. Starting off at number 10, it's Brawlhalla, which, if you're familiar with the brawler fighting game style game, as a lot of you are, Super Smash Bros. Brawl being a favorite, of course, basically establishing the full genre, then you may have heard of Brawlhalla. And in truth, we don't normally do this, but this is coming out in a couple of days, as opposed to during the course of July. It's something that we kind of have kicked back and forth a lot during July because we like this game and wanted to talk about it because it's really a good Brawl game that you may have played elsewhere on PC, on PlayStation, etc., etc. And if you're interested in having it on your phone, you're going to want to go to brawlhalla.com/play and pre-register for Android or iOS. But what's really cool is that there is going to be cross-play with every single other platform, so assuming the port is good, you're going to have a nice large amount of people to play against. And again, Brawlhalla is just an absolute ton of fun. At number 9 is Hellrider 3, a game that is the third in a series that takes a pretty big turn. If you've ever played the previous games, they're kind of somewhere between Excitebike and Crossy Road. The general main way that these games play out isn't necessarily entirely different. However, the change in 3D perspective adds a lot of detail, as well as a lot of urgency and energy to the gameplay. You're still avoiding obstacles, you're still attacking enemies with weapons, getting power-ups, etc., etc. But again, it feels a little bit more frenetic. The pace seems a little bit higher on account you feel as though you're part of the action rather than looking top-down. And I have to say, overall, it's a good move. I like both versions of this game. I like Hellrider 1 and 2. However, to make a third one, I think necessitates trying something new, and I think that they succeeded in what they tried. Hellrider 3 is available on iOS and Android right now. At number 8 is Win Wing, a bullet hell where you're spending your time collecting like a roguelike, and you're essentially modifying your airplane that you are fighting back against an alien horde and hopefully protecting the Earth. Obviously, they're not going to win, like, a prize for original story or anything, but they're not going for that. It's, I mean, like most of these games, an excuse to have a good bullet hell. And this is a good bullet hell. It's also different enough looking that it kind of feels like playing something different. I haven't really played a bullet hell that looks like this, and a lot of the time that's actually a big factor in if you want to play a bullet hell. A, if the gameplay is good, and B, if the aesthetic is good. And I'm gonna go ahead and say that both of these pretty much nail it. It's absolutely 100% the bullet hell to try this month. It's called Win Wing again. It's out on iOS and Android right now. At number 7 is Soul Worker Anime Legends, which is based off of the PC game Soul Worker. It's an action RPG with multiplayer elements, with both PvP or PvE co-op. Now for me, what makes this one stand out over other games that are kind of like this, and there are plenty, is just the fluidity of battle. Like, obviously on-screen controls aren't completely ideal, but this is one that I think really manages to take advantage of the screen real estate without getting in the way, but also feeling very natural, I guess, for lack of a better term. The buttons don't feel like I have to aim for the buttons. I got very used to it very quick. And that may have something to do with the size of my phone. I don't really know 100%. All I will say is that I really enjoyed my time with this, and it was entirely based on the fact that the battle felt fluid and enjoyable. As far as PvP, I didn't really do a whole lot of that. I did more PvE, and I found it to be pretty well put together. The missions are pretty good, and I can see myself playing more of it. Soul Worker Anime Legends is out on iOS and Android right now. At number 6 is Soda Dungeon 2, which is more or less a turn-based dungeon crawler where the point is to recruit a team, go down into a dungeon, get loot, build your tavern slash town, and there's even some interesting stuff like crafting and various slightly more management-seeming systems. Nothing too heavy, but I mean, there's a pretty fair amount of depth for the type of game that this is, and on top of that, it's really fun. They're also pretty good about free-to-play stuff. You can do everything with in-game currency. Obviously, there's, you know, monetization stuff in it, as there are in every game on this list. But this is an overall incredibly fun game that gives you a lot of different types of gameplay while wrapping it neatly in a dungeon crawler skin. If you've played the first, it's actually quite a bit of an improvement. There's a lot more to do, it's a lot more flexible, and frankly, I found it more absorbing. Soda Dungeon 2 is out on iOS and Android right now. At number 5 is Emergent Fates, a RPG that I would say really molds itself along the lines of a JRPG. It's a turn-based, linear, story-based RPG with a very JRPG-like system. It also has a very unique art style for that type of a game, looking more like a storybook or even like a 90s computer game in some respects. You don't really see that as a choice too often, and it's a welcome one because it actually does feel pretty unique and the art itself is quite nice. Now, I haven't gone ahead and beaten this game or anything, so I can't tell you if the story wraps up all neat and tidy. I will say it has been intriguing and I have enjoyed the battle system as well as the music quite a bit. It's absorbed me in. It's given me Chrono Trigger vibes as well as some Persona vibes in terms of how it's put together. Definitely an enjoyable game. It's currently free on iOS. It is not out on Android as of yet, but I do like it quite a bit, so I hope that it does land on that platform because I generally use an Android. At number 4 is Tales of Crystoria, a proper JRPG from Bandai Namco Entertainment. It is 100% a Tales universe game made specifically for mobile, and it does bring in the same JRPG gameplay we've come to expect from the series, but it does a little work to adapt it to mobile that I think is definitely worthwhile on account. I mean, it really just plays out like exactly the type of experience you'd want getting a Tales game on mobile. Again, this is a long game. I haven't beaten it or anything, but I'm certainly intrigued by the story. Definitely happy with the battle system. It's classic Tales, and it's out right now on iOS and Android. At number 3 is Battle Legion, an auto battler, which honestly, I think this game is really fun. It's kind of like, and please understand I'm using kind of very liberally here, kind of like auto chess and kind of like Clash Royale and kind of a tower defense game without having towers. It's pretty great. I really like how this game's put together. You make your battle formations and then just press battle. It happens. Battles are usually less than 20 seconds. They're pretty fun to watch, and you also learn pretty quickly what you can do and can't do. There is PvP. It is fun. I do like playing it quite a bit. And honestly, like, it's just a really good, quick strategy game that creates a fun spectacle. Battle Legion is out on iOS and Android now. I'd highly recommend this one. At number 2 is Sinnoh Alice. It's a game that's a little bit more complicated than your typical mobile RPG, of this nature at least. It's not particularly straightforward, but it is directed by Yoko Taro. It is absolutely a very interesting, kind of bizarre, original story that involves a bunch of fairy tale characters more or less becoming killers. It's kind of a weird setup though, and that's perhaps my only real complaint about it, is that it's a game that it takes a while to understand. Like, it's got a class system that I'm not going to be able to explain here at all. And sometimes the story is a little slow moving. However, everything else about it, presentation, gameplay, etc., I don't have complaints about. And it's one that I could see myself definitely finishing, even though it's a little bit of a slog at times. It's a slog that, for whatever reason, has me like infinitely interested. And I think it's the atmosphere, because it really nails that. Sinnoh Alice is out on iOS and Android right now. At number 1 is Guardian Tales, a game that is going to give you some serious Legend of Zelda vibes. It's a little faster in pace and a lot more puzzle-oriented, which I think really brings together a package that works really well. I enjoy the hell out of Guardian Tales. It's a game that I think brings something at least a little new to the table. It feels fresh, although that is kind of in the overall feel of the game as opposed to really introducing extremely innovative new gameplay ideas. I mean, there's a lot that's familiar here, but I really enjoy it, and it doesn't feel like a retread of anything, and that's what I like about it. Guardian Tales is out on iOS and Android right now. Couple of bonus games for you. These are the paid games. The first is Mud Runner Mobile, which comes to us for $5.99. It is an off-roading simulation with pretty phenomenal graphics for a mobile game. Next is Pascal's Wager, which is $3.99, out on iOS and Android. Pascal's Wager is a Soulsborne-like, and I'll say that this game manages to create an aesthetic that is both unique and reminiscent of those games. The gameplay is quite good, might I add. Next is Thronebreaker: The Witcher Tales, which is, believe it or not, a single-player campaign for Gwent. It's $9.99 on iOS and Android now. And finally, Layton: The Unwound Future in HD, which of course is the third Professor Layton game. It's remastered in HD. It's phenomenal. Professor Layton's a great series. It is a bit hefty at $15.99, but it is also worth it if you like that type of gameplay. I personally do. And what did you end up playing this month? Leave us a comment. Let us know what you think. If you like this video, click like. If you're not subscribed, now's a great time to do so. We upload brand new videos every day of the week. Best way to see them first is, of course, a subscription. So click subscribe. Don't forget to enable all notifications. And as always, we thank you very much for watching this video. I'm Falcon. You can follow me on Twitter, Falcon the Hero. We'll see you next time right here on Game Ranks.